In this video, I will talk about an application of the news vendor inventory model in the capacity-controlled fair for revenue management. We introduced the news vendor inventory model in a previous video. The problem can be described like this.
A newspaper vendor must decide how many copies of the day's newspaper to stock in the morning.
The demand is uncertain. Unsold copies due to overstocking will have little value at the end of the day. Unmet demand due to understocking will result in lost sales. What is the best quantity of newspapers that will minimize the expected total cost? The key characteristic of this type of problems is that they involve a penalty or cost for both overstocking and understocking because the demand is uncertain. We found out that the optimal quantity X star is determined so that the overstocking probability or the probability of the demand Y being less than or equal to the order quantity X star is equal to this ratio, the unit understocking cost over the sum of the unit overstocking cost and the unit understocking cost. Also, the understocking probability or the probability of the demand Y being greater than or equal to the order quantity X star is equal to this ratio, the unit overstocking cost over the sum of the unit overstocking cost and the unit understocking cost. The news vendor model can be useful in many other applications that have nothing to do with newspapers at all. For example, it can be used to model and solve revenue management problems. Revenue management is used to analyze consumer behavior and adjust the product availability and price to maximize revenue. The goal of revenue management is to sell the right product to the right people at the right time for the right price. Revenue management originated in the airline industry and soon spread to other industries. Nowadays, almost all major airlines, hotel firms, cruise lines, rental car firms, sports events, live shows, and movie theaters have implemented revenue management systems to predict the customer demand and optimize available price. Revenue management is also growing in the retail industry that involve perishable products like groceries, seasonal products like clothes, and products that quickly become obsolete like high-tech devices. A typical revenue management problem is called the capital controlled fair, or the early bird discount. Let's use an example to illustrate the problem and the model. A hotel in New York City has an inventory of I is equal to 100 rooms. The hotel offers two fares to its customers. If a customer books early, he or she can enjoy the discounted fare, PD, at $180 per room. After a certain number of rooms have been booked at the discounted fare, the hotel will start to take the reservations for all the remaining rooms at the full fare, PF, which is $250 per room. We assume the demand for the discounted fare rooms is abundant. The demand Y for full fare rooms is uncertain, but it follows a normal distribution with mean 80 and a standard deviation 20. If the hotel sells all the rooms at the discounted fare, it may lose revenue because some rooms could have been sold at the full fare.
The hotel needs to decide how many rooms must be protected and only sold at the full fare so that the expected total revenue is maximized or the expected total cost is minimized.
Let X be the protection level, the number of full fare rooms. So 100 minus X is the booking limit on the discounted fare rooms. That means, after 100 minus X rooms have been booked at the discounted fare, the hotel should start to take reservations at the full fare. We know the demand follows a normal distribution. Let FY be the probability density function, capital FY be the cumulative distribution function for the demand Y. We can convert this problem to a news vendor problem because it involves overstocking cost and understocking cost. the unit overstocking cost CO is equal to PD. If the demand Y is less than X, then the hotel protected too many full fare rooms. X minus Y rooms will be empty, and they could have been sold at a discounted fare PD. The unit understocking cost CU is equal to PF minus PD. If the demand Y is greater than X, then the hotel protected too few full fare rooms. Y minus X rooms could have been sold at the full fare PF instead of the discounted fare PD. The goal of this problem is to find the optimal stock level X star that minimizes the expected total overstocking and understocking costs. The discounted fare is $180 per room, and the full fare is $250 per room. The unit overstocking cost CO is equal to the discounted fare, $180 per room. The unit understocking cost CU is equal to the full fare minus the discounted fare, $250 minus $180. It is equal to $70. We can see that the overstocking penalty is greater than the understocking penalty. Let's use this formula to calculate the overstocking probability. It is equal to 28%. We use this formula to calculate the understocking probability. It is equal to 72%. The probability of overstocking is less than the probability of understocking. The reasoning behind this is that because the overstocking cost or penalty is greater than the understocking cost or penalty, we need to determine the quantity X star so the vendor will have a lower probability of overstocking than understocking. Now the demand Y follows the normal distribution. This figure shows the probability density function of a general normal distribution with mean mu and standard deviation sigma. The overstocking probability is equal to the area represented by the shaded area. We can convert it to a standard normal cumulative distribution, and it is equal to phi x star minus mu over sigma. Here is a cumulative distribution function. We also know that the overstocking probability is equal to 28%, so we have this equation. Let's use the inverse standard normal cumulative distribution calculator to find the value of this item. The link to this online calculator is given below this video. In this box, type the probability value 0.28. Choose the inverse is equal to minus 0.583. Finally, the optimal quantity X star is equal to 68.3 rooms. That means 68 full fare rooms should be protected. This implies that the total inventory I minus X star is the maximum number of reservations that should be sold at the discounted fare. This number is 32. Okay, this is the application of the news vendor inventory model in the capacity controlled fare for revenue management. Thanks for watching.